Copy the first expansion. Damage, resolve. Let that resolve, and then you get the idea. Hello and welcome to another Magic Arena deck take, this time featuring Teemo Control, or Ral Control as I like to call it nowadays, with the upgrade from War of the Spark. Let's quickly go over the win condition, which is expansion, or rather the explosion half. 2 blue, 2 red, X. Explosion deals X damage to any target. Target player draws X card. And this basically helps us kill big threats, be it creatures or planeswalkers, and later in the game hit our opponent for lots of damage in the face, in combination with Wilderness Reclamation, which untaps our lands in the end step, basically doubling all our mana and enabling the huge damage spells. But how do we get there to the late game? We do have card selection opt, the mainstay for blue decks. I like to say time and time again, very important card to fix our draws, to get all the land drops, which are in this deck especially important because of Growth Spiral, because we draw a card and then we may put a land card from our hand onto the battlefield, which allows us to ramp into Wilderness Reclamation one turn sooner. So play this on turn two, put a third land in play. On our third turn, put a fourth land, cast Wilderness Reclamation, untap our lands, and then cast Chemist's Insight all in one turn. So very nice synergy here. Another piece of synergy that came into the deck is Ral's Outburst. 4 mana, Ral's Outburst deals 3 damage to any target. Look at the top 2 cards of a library. Put one of them into your hand and the other into your graveyard. So basically, a little combination of anything that the Ral Planeswalkers do. They deal damage, they have us look at our cards, basically the old Ral. The new one is also in our deck, but we get to that later. So this is very important because it is, on the one hand, card selection lets us dig deeper into our deck to find the cards we need. And on the other hand, it's 3 damage, which helps us survive. We do have still 4 Shocks, 2 Lava Coil and 2 Fiery Cannonade. But with this, I think we do hit the critical mass of removal to survive long enough to pull our win combination off. Before this, the deck was a little bit bad against aggro, like the aggressive red decks, since it had a few removal spells, but not quite enough to deal with all the pressure to our life totals. And with this, I think we are in a good spot. We are still good against control, especially in our sideboard, but we'll get to that later as well. Let's talk about Ral Storm Conduit, which is also a new addition in the deck. It reads +2, scry 1, which is good to find what we need, but most importantly, -2. When you cast the next instance or sorcery spell this turn, copy that spell. You may choose new targets for the copy, and with this, we only need 7 mana, Wilderness Reclamation in play, and an explosion, and then basically float the 7 mana, tap the other 7, cast an explosion for 10, have it doubled, and then deal 20 to our opponent. Or rather, we don't even. We need only 6 mana because we only need to cast this for 9. Because Ral has the passive ability, whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, Ral Storm Conduit deals 1 damage to target, opponent, or planeswalker. So with this we can kill them instantly, but also stuff like Ral's Outburst to the face gets to be, if we copy it, 8 mana, 8 damage. Plus we get to look at the best, at the top 4 cards and take the 2 of the best of them, and it can copy the Chemist's Insight, it can copy the Fiery Cannonade to kill bigger things, it can get way more lands into play, we can kill 2 big creatures and all of the good stuff. And there's also a very nice instant win combo that requires only 5 mana, which is cast a cheap spell, in this case an opt or a shock, then copy that with expansion, and then cast another expansion on the first expansion, and then keep copying the first expansion, because the copy can cast, can expand on the first one, and again and again and again. And with everything of these instantly loops expansion, we deal 1 damage to our opponent, and basically instantly killing them. This is a lot easier in Paperweight. You can just explain the combo and then basically say, okay, you die now. In Arena, you have to go through the motions and do it all unless your opponent is so kind as to survive. But yeah, as for lands, 7 of the blue green and the red green lands and 8 of the blue red ones, as well as 2 islands and a mountain. The blue red is important because we still have Niv-Mizzet in the sideboard. He was the win condition before War of the Spark, but he was a little bit, a lot slower, costing 6 mana and all. But he's still there, the control killer is not forgotten, just benched for now. We do also have a Mornigate and a Sorceress Spyglass against control, as well as a Legion Warboss as kind of a pressure. There are 2 more Lava Coils to deal with bigger creatures. Not sure if we may change those out for Beacon Bolts later down the line. We'll have to see how the meta evolves. Another Crushing Canopies for big flyers, and another addition from War of the Spark, the Living Twister, which comes in against aggro as well. A 2/5 body for 3 is already good on its own, but with the ability to discard a land card and then have him deal 2 damage to any target, as well as return a tapped land you control to its owner's hand, it's basically continuous damage. I'm not even sure if I want this against control as well. It is good because of the buddy against control, but I think against aggro, but as control, I think it's good as well because once it is on the battlefield, it can pose quite the threat with lots of damage. But yeah, this is the deck list so far, and I am loving it right now. I've played a few games with it, a lot games to be honest, which I can't say for the other decks I've been trying in this standard, but this deck just feels good, because it's basically a very nice working deck before, and it has been upgraded to be way better with Ral and Ral's Outburst, and I like how it works, how you sometimes get the instant win if you don't play against the deck with counter magic, so you can just do the little instant kill combo, so very nice, and I'm pretty sure this is what I am going to play going forward, and this hand is fine. We do have Ral's Outburst and 2 Ral's, so we can risk minusing him and then doing this in the next turn, and we have Shock against early aggression. Yeah, let's keep this. Don't have any of the other combo pieces yet, but from my experience we can draw into those quite easily later. So let's see what we are playing against. Okay, it seems to be some kind of either Dimir or Esper. Could be Grixis as well. Will it be control? I don't know. There's also lots of Esper mid range running around right now, but this seems to be... Well, we can't really say anything about that because the mid range decks also play Thought Erasure, and I think they are going to pick Outburst? Not sure actually. Oh, Aral. So they seem to be having a removal for that, which is okay. And Wilderness Reclamation. Nice. Let's hope that they do play something this turn. Not that. Well, at least we can play either the Reclamation or Aral now. And do they have a land in hand, or are they searching for it? Not sure. Okay, so the second Ral's gun. Which makes me a little bit sad, but... it is Esper. So I guess they do have Mortify, if not in hand, at least in their deck. If they do, that could be problematic. but it seems like they don't. Okay, so let's use the mana in the face. We want to find new stuff. Another Ral's Outburst. Okay, why not? Let's, ooh, this is good. Do we want to Ralts Outburst now or expansion? I guess we Ralts Outburst now. Okay, so they may have, okay. Do I want another one? Nah, I guess we do want the land. Because big explosion. So I'm pretty sure they do have a counter spell. So, oh, Dawn of Hope. Interesting tech. Not sure about it though. Growth Spiral. Do they have negate main board? Do I want to try? We can cast it for 5, which is fine. Yeah, let's risk it. Okay, so it was most likely an absorb. Oh, we could have for 6. I am stupid. But then again, we have shock open now. yeah, we have enough green blue. Let's go with steam vents. So what are you doing? I'm pretty sure you won't be. Okay, search for a scunter is fine right now. Pass, and I guess I'll hit you in the face. Ah, yeah, okay. So I'm not sure if this was a bad draw from them. They took 2 of our routes, which would have made our hand even better. I mean, think about being able to copy those outbursts. Whew, that would have been nice. Yeah, but our deck did what it was supposed to do, and I think that is very good. This hand is pretty keepable. We do have Reclamation and Insight, which is always a good combination. And let's see what we are playing against. Okay, Mirror question mark? Simic Nexus, maybe? Merfolk even? Nah, I'm kidding, it's probably Teemo or Nexus. But does Nexus play Growth Spiral? Yeah, must be. Oh, Narset. This could be a problem for us. So I guess we are going to shock her. But then again. Oh, Teferi. Huh. So. Bunch Planeswalkers? Must be. Breeding pool. Yes. And then I'm going to either shock her or copy something. So it is some kind of ramp Super Friends deck, I guess? But I wouldn't play the. Well, it might be good against control. I don't know. Let's kill Narset because next turn. Okay, they most likely don't have a counter spell because. Then they would have gotten. Not permission. Oh, god damn it! Stop giving up all the time. Again, our deck did what it was supposed to do. I don't know what to say otherwise. It's not my fault that our opponents do seem to be a little bit unlucky with their draws. But this deck is very good at not doing anything. Like, okay, opponent goes first. I think I'm going to mulligan this because we do need blue. This looks fine. Yeah, as much as I like this, we do need another land, especially since we have Growth Spiral. since we... Oh, wait. This is mono red. Do I want to shock myself? Yes, I guess it's in the long run, if I can shock something of his that is helping me. This pyromancer, for example. Yeah, get shocked. Another growth spiral. Nice. A little bit of a problem that I don't have a second blue mana saw or land, because then I could have cast the opt this turn. Ah, risk factor. Yep. Sure. Take four. Ooh, a row. Another land would be nice now. Thank you. Do I want to shot myself though? I kind of don't. He has still four cards left in hand. They're also expensive. Do I have to go for the risk here? I think I do.
Every problem has a
Let's have a look.
Let's start by taking you out of the equipment. Guild mage,
planeswalker,
genius inventor. I got it all.
Yeah, I think I have to draw this. If he decides to empty his hand with lots of creatures. Okay. Is he deciding to kill Raal? Okay, he isn't. Damn it! Could you please kill Raal, maybe? No? Oh, and light up the stage. And another light up the stage. Phew. Let's double camp this inside.
There's plenty more where that came from.
Yep. One damage for you, and another damage for you. Draw two. Nice. Draw two. Ooh. Do I want to opt? Do I need to opt? I don't think I need to opt. I don't know what opting now would do, actually. The problem is that we can only explosion for two now. And he has the damages in hand. A wilderness reclamation would have most likely won us this now. Maybe I can still find one. No. Okay. I think I want to draw two more cards, four more cards. And an outburst. And another row. This is not helping. Well, if he has any kind of burn spell, and he will most likely draw one with the risk factor. We lost, but we were missing a pretty crucial piece. Yeah, I have to decline, and pretty sure he did draw something. Oh, light up the stage. He didn't, actually. Okay, we do have one more turn to win. Which we can't. I mean... Oh, wait. I am the stupidest person in the world. Talking about the endless combo. Let's put full control mode on, shall we? Let's opt. Deal the damage. Yeah, resolve that. Then expansion. Copy the opt. Damage. Resolve. Second expansion. Copy the first expansion. Damage. Resolve. Resolve. Copy the first expansion. Damage. Resolve. Resolve. Copy the first expansion. Damage. Resolve. Let that resolve, and then you get the idea. Unless you do something wrong here, this basically wins you the game. And as he is so nice not to give up, we can do it for the full life that he has left. I can't believe I almost gave this up again. I had it all in my hand and didn't think about it. Isn't this nice? Win. Copy again. Ping. I'm not sure if he wants to give me the nice experience of actually doing that because he wants me to do it for positive reasons or because he's like, well, fuck you. But then again, instant win combo. Bring us to gold 3. Yeah, so... I do like this. Let's do a final one. You should stop... the god dragon bolas. You should stop when it's nicest, but this is just working so well. I can't keep myself from trying this more. Okay, Gruul. What do I want to do? I don't have any turn 2 plays yet. I think I can. Let's opt turn 1. Okay, incubation druid. Another opt? Don't think so. Shock. That's nice indeed. Ooh. Do you see it? We do have it again. Let's shock this right away. Don't want him to get the mana out of it. Could have waited a turn if he played something smaller. And I would like a land now. Because if we can find a Ral and a cheap spell. Ooh, Wenifer. Good thing... We do have the Lava Coil in hand. Another opt. Let's look for the land first. No, Shock would be fine as well, but yeah, there's the land. Tap, dead, Lava Coil, that. And it's actually Teemo list as well, but with a Prime Speaker, Venifar. Oh! The race boar. Holy guacamole. I think we do need to win via this again. Because this, what does it do again? Attacks and may put a creature upon the end of the battlefield attacking. Eesh. Piora, okay. And I'm pretty sure he does have something else that he can put onto the battlefield attacking now. Rhythm of the Wild. Please don't let him have a big creature. Does he? Damn it! Holy shit! Okay. So what are my options here? Return the creature to your hand. Yeah, sure. I think I'm Ral's outbursting and trying to find a Ral. That's not a Ral. Let's take the land then. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and that is enough to kill the race boar. So let's do that. We set the stop. Tap our mana. Four and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Resolve and 5, 6, 7, 8. Kill the race boar. Draw the cards. Oh wait, never mind. We lost anyway because this gives this haste. Okay, couldn't find Ral. Ah, I knew I wasn't thinking about something. Yeah, the combination of haste and big stuff. Did he have the mana? I'm pretty sure he did. He had 5. Could untap one with Kiora. Okay, yeah, we were dead. I didn't give up too fast this time. Okay, yeah, okay. As we see, if you get comboed like that, you can't win. But, well, there wasn't a Ral anyway, so it wouldn't have worked. Either way, yeah, that was... No, not profile. Dex. That was a Ral Reclamation, or Teemo Reclamation, the War of the Spark updated version. As I said before, I like it very much. We even got to show off the one-turn kill combo, and I like that pretty much as well. I can honestly only tell you to try this deck out. It's tons of fun to play, it's fairly consistent, and yeah, basically a blast. Yeah, that's it for today. Have fun playing yourself. May the draws always be in your favor. If you do want to see any other decks, write that in the comments. Misplays and stuff could go there as well. If you like the content I'm creating, please think about liking the video and even subscribing to the channel to not miss anything and help me out there. That's it for today. Goodbye. Ciao.